Let's dive deeper into the action with our markets reporters. Equities, bonds, currencies, commodities. Luke, at the close, what were you watching?
So Scarlett there had a good reference about what was going on with treasuries in the past. Let's look at what the market thinks is going to happen with treasuries in the future. So here we've got a chart showing you both the 10-year yield and the one-year forward 10-year yield, market implied expectations for that 10-year yield, and the difference between them on the bottom panel here. So what we've got here essentially you'll see is that throughout the course of the year, people became very much doubting around the time of the Fed's first rate cut and the time that the U.S. dollar offshore yuan broke 7, you'll see a sharp move downwards there in the yellow lines and the purple lines. That's everyone beginning to think Fed's behind the curve, we're in for a global recession, world is over. Ever since then, you see both of those measures picking up, but one more than the other. We've essentially got back to the point where traders are expecting about 10 basis points worth of a rise in the 10-year yield over the next year, even though the U.S. dollar offshore yuan has not weakened that much since then. So Jessica, to me, this is mainly a story of, hey, obviously trade is playing a role in markets, is playing a role in driving global yields, but also there's something beyond that, and that's the global data getting less worse that has helped change that picture.
Very interesting, Luke. Well, I am taking a look at crude oil after last week's gain. It looks like the bears are taking control of the market here. West Texas Intermediate crude closed lower by 1.2%, just around $57 a barrel there. Again, it's the trade war that's really weighing on oil, gripping the market in fear. Now, I also want to dive a little deeper. If you just jump into my terminal, I want to show you another chart here. It's WTI's prompt spread we're looking at, which is trading in contango, a structure that really signals weakness. So we're seeing flat price weakness, spreads weakness. We want to see if this contango deepens. Taylor.
Well, Jessica, one thing I'm taking a look at is shares of Apple. They just continue to make more and more record highs. It seems to be almost every day in the last few sessions. The first came on Friday. This is after Dan Ives raised his price target to a straight high on iPhone 11 demand. And then today we got more data that in official government data was showing that Apple shipped 10 million iPhone 11s in China during September and October. That would give us the first indication of how the phone is doing in China. And it is up about 6% year over year. Now, what that means is if you come and take a look at a chart here that I'm showing in my terminal. Last week, I mentioned how Apple's market cap was more than the entire S&P 500 energy index. Today, I'm showing a chart that shows that Apple and Microsoft have a higher market cap than the entire consumer staples sector within the S&P 500. On Friday, they had a market cap of about $2.32 trillion. That's more than the $2.14 trillion of the consumer staples sector, and up now from those December 24th lows by about $900 billion.